Because monthly rent payments are usually the exact same every month, you can ask QuickBooks to automatically make the invoices for the tenants at the end of each month. That's because QuickBooks has a memorized transaction feature that is very, very easy to use. There are simple steps to automate rent invoices, and you could pause the video and write them down. But even though I'm going to show you the steps written out here in words, you might not need to write it down because it really is common sense and very intuitive as you go to do it. First, you open the most recent invoice for the tenant whose monthly invoices you wish to automate. Then you click Memorize from the main tab in the ribbon, and I'm going to show you where that is. Then you have to give the memorized transaction a name. You have to choose Automate Transaction Entry rather than just ask QuickBooks to remind you. You then have to tell QuickBooks that this particular invoice will be monthly when you choose a time period for how often QuickBooks will make the invoice. Then you will choose next date and put the date of what the very next invoice should be for that tenant. And the other two fields you can leave blank, and you'll see how to do this in a moment. So each invoice month will be exactly the same most of the time. So this should work. And of course, if something happens where a tenant's rent changes for a monthly amount, you could always edit the invoice or edit the memorized transaction list. The first step is to find the most recent invoice for the tenant whose invoices you wish to automate. The best way to do that is to click the tenant's balance detail. So, who do we want to automate? Well, how about let's automate Dave's invoice and see what happens. Okay, so we look at Dave. We see that the latest invoice for Dave was February 28. Let's double click and open up this invoice. Remember, the ribbon can be collapsed or opened in any transaction window in QuickBooks, and the ribbon has different tabs. In the main tab of the invoice ribbon, there's a button called Memorize. When we click this, it will say the name of the customer as the name of the transaction. We can leave the name of the customer and apartment number as the name of the transaction. And if you want, you can click and change it to whatever you'd like. But in our case, we would like QuickBooks to automatically enter the invoice because Holden earned the money just because Dave stays, whether Dave pays or not. Now, how often to automate? Well, we know this will be monthly. And the next date will be the very next monthly invoice. So if the date of the invoice in question is February 28th, that means the date of the next invoice, by the way, make sure you're in year 2017, will be March 31st of 2017. And we can leave number remaining and days in advance to enter blank, and everything will work out fine. Now, when we click OK, we can close this, and to prove that this has been automated, we can go into the list main menu and open up the memorized transaction list. If we stretch it out wider, we can see this is the only memorized transaction in this file. If you want to edit the invoice for things like the monthly rent, you can double click and change anything on the invoice you want, and QuickBooks will remember to do it the way it was after you changed it. If you wish to change how it's automated, you can select it, select the specific memorized transaction. In this case, there's only one. And in the bottom left, click Memorize and then Edit Transaction. And then you go back to the window where you put in the terms of the memorization and the terms of the automation, and you can change it from monthly to something else, or change the next date, or anything you want. Now, in order to really see how this works, let's quit QuickBooks, then change the date in the computer to a month later. Then we'll reopen QuickBooks and see that QuickBooks automatically makes the next invoice. I'm going to close QuickBooks up here in the top right corner, but you can't quite see it. Back up now? No. Now, as QuickBooks is quitting, I'm going to click on the clock settings because I happen to have permissions to do so in my own computer. And the way to do that, which by the way you shouldn't really do, is click here, click change date and time, click change date and time, and I'm going to go forward to April 2 of 2017, which is approximately 1 month after the last invoice. And then click OK. Now I have successfully fooled my computer and tricked it into believing it is now April 2nd of 2017, which is a month after Dave's last invoice. Now I'm going to open the QuickBooks file. And look what's going to happen as soon as we open the QuickBooks file. Okay, click cancel for the nonsense message. Don't worry. Aha! This window pops up and says, enter memorized transactions. So this is the only memorized transaction on the memorized transaction list. You have one memorized transactions to be entered now. If I click enter checked, which means the one that's checked off, now, boom, QuickBooks has automatically entered one memorized transaction. And now, when we maximize QuickBooks, we can see that if we open the tenant balance detail for Dave, aha, we now have a March 31 invoice that was entered for $1,000 of Dave's rent. And you can do that with all your tenants using the memorized transaction list.